So if you want to do well in chemistry, you need to understand electronegativity. So we're going to look at the definition, the trends, and then why those trends happen. Let's get started. When we're talking about electronegativity of an element, let's say chlorine, chlorine's more electronegative than hydrogen. And what that means is it's going to pull the electrons in the chemical bond, that's right here, closer to it, like this here. So we're interested in the electrons involved in the bond between atoms. We don't really care about the lone pairs up here. Because of that, electrons are negative. There'll be more electrons around chlorine. It'll be a little bit more negative, have a partial negative charge. Hydrogen will have a partial positive charge. And you can think of the surface of the molecule like this. The red's more negative, blue more positive. It's a polar molecule. So electronegativity, that helps us understand polarity. So pause and answer this question. Which electrons are attracted to the more electronegative element? In this case, chlorine. So we can see it's those electrons right here in the chemical bond that are attracted to the more electronegative element. Important to know. So let's look at the trends for electronegativity on the periodic table. So the easiest way to do this is remember that fluorine right here, fluorine is the most electronegative. So as we go across the periodic table towards fluorine, electronegativity increases. Oxygen is more electronegative than nitrogen. Nitrogen, more electronegative than carbon. When we go up a group towards fluorine, electronegativity increases. So fluorine's the most, the next is chlorine, then bromine and iodine down that group. That's the trend, remember that, and you'll always know which is more electronegative. So give it a try. Which is more electronegative, nitrogen or carbon? Nitrogen is closer to fluorine, it's more electronegative. How about boron or aluminum? Here, boron is closer, just a little bit, to fluorine, more electronegative. It's also in the same period, or row. About sodium and potassium. So remember, as we move away from fluorine down a group like that, it becomes less electronegative. So potassium is less electronegative, and it's just a little bit further from fluorine. Okay, I think you got it. A question you'll probably be asked, though, is why is that the case? Why is that trend occur? Two big reasons. The first one, as we go down, we're adding energy levels. So down here with 6 energy levels, we have a pretty low electronegativity. But fluorine, with only 2, it's very high. In general, we ignore these noble gases here. So let's try to visualize that. So fluorine is above chlorine on the periodic table. Remember, it's the most electronegative. So we're going down a group here, and you can see we added an energy level. We have 1, 2 here. We have 1, 2, 3 with chlorine. Chlorine's a bigger atom, and there's an extra electron shell or energy level. That means it's going to shield whatever tries to bond with it from the positive nucleus. Because of that, it won't pull the electrons in the bond very well. It's going to be less electronegative. Fluorine, on the other hand, its positively charged nucleus is kind of closer to whatever it bonds to, and it can pull those electrons towards it. It's very electronegative. That's the first trend. The next trend is as we go across a period. So on the periodic table, going across, we have nitrogen, then oxygen, then fluorine. So oxygen's more electronegative, it's closer to fluorine. And here's the reason. We have the same number of energy levels or shells, so that doesn't matter when we go across the period. If we look at the periodic table, the atomic number, number of protons, oxygen has 1 more proton. And that means it's a little bit more positive here in the nucleus. It can pull electrons in a chemical bond towards it more strongly than nitrogen. That means it's more electronegative. It's because it has more positive charge, and it can pull electrons in a chemical bond towards it. So that's the big idea. The more electronegative element, chlorine, can pull the electrons in the chemical bond there closer to it. And when we do that, we get a partial negative charge. Hydrogen is positive. We'll get a polar molecule. So the electronegativity, more electronegative, that pulls these electrons in the bond closer. And we can look at the trend on the periodic table. And remember that fluorine is the most electronegative. Going down a group, it decreases because we're adding energy levels. going across towards fluorine, it increases because we've added more positive charge, more protons. This is Dr. B. Thanks for watching.